Yes.
And
his number is.
And I'm going to make sure, because of Murphy's Law, that we're going to give you our backup number as well, okay?
Perfect.
Okay.
Thanks, Alex.
Hey, thank you so much, and I'll talk to you in 48. Well, no, yeah, it's in 3 days, so we'll talk to you Thursday.
Excellent. Thanks, Alex.
Thank you, Doctor. Take care. Okay, folks, we're going to come back. I'm going to allow myself a lavish two-minute break here to go to the little boys' room. You know, I think fitting into this whole Hellraiser theme, and that's what it is, by the elites, come in with the, you didn't play while I was gone, that one intro where Walter Cronkite's talking about how much he loves Satan.
No, I did not play that.
Yeah, let's play that one for folks, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
We are in process of developing a whole series of techniques which will enable the controlling oligarchy to get people actually to love their servitude. People can be made to enjoy a state of affairs which, by any decent standard, they ought not to enjoy.
Perhaps you had better start from the beginning. Perhaps you had better start from the beginning. Perhaps you had better start from the beginning.
Too many kids are what's making the planet worse.
A lot of these kids come from bad gene pools. They don't have stable parents making good decisions.
Mercury-containing vaccines may help, not harm kids, according to two new studies in the journal Pediatrics. These new studies suggest that the opposite, that the preservatives may actually be associated with improved behavior and mental performance.
Fluoride in water is supposed to fight tooth decay, but could it also cause cancer?
Turns out the government had the right under U.S. law to conduct secret testing on the American public under specific conditions.
We have to work the dark side, or we're going to spend time in the shadows.
Any attempt to achieve world order must be the work of the devil. Well, join me. I'm glad to sit here at the right hand of Satan.
There's a need for a new world order. Someday, in the next few years, a solution will emerge.
I know there's a lot of people out there that try to deny the issues we cover here out of fear. Because there are real monsters in this world. And they control the heights above us. They introduce the poisons into the food supply, the water we drink, the air we breathe. They are releasing plagues upon the earth. They are drunk on the blood of billions. They have sold us that hundreds of millions of aborted children is a beautiful thing, that euthanized elderly is a wonderful right, that sodium fluoride and GMO foods and small children with cell phones microwaving their brains is good. And rather than reject their lie, we're so afraid we say, I'll just rationalize to myself and say that everything's okay and the New World Order loves me. Gene in Texas, John in Virginia, and others that are holding. We're going to take your calls for the balance of the show. I had a lot of notes that I wrote up last night. One of my daughter's doodles on the back. But three pages of handwritten and typed notes that I meant to go over. And it's all just too important to do it at the end of the show because I'm exhausted right now for some reason. It doesn't even bother me when people attack me for my own self. I don't even care. Facing all of this, like, blast your ego away. I mean, I'd love to be able to enjoy my little status and people knowing who I am. I'd love to be able to, be a guy out doing good work, but, you know, still enjoying it and enjoying the fight. I don't enjoy any of it. I take heart in the children we save from CPS by educating parents about the traps, or get people that get off of GMO foods or at least reduce it, or people that don't vaccinate their children, or people that find out. But it's like, I'm so busy trying to warn other people that don't know that, you know, as we save people, for every person we save, we lose 1,000. And so I'm just so focused on all the carnage and destruction I see and all the horrible things I see happening to humanity that, I mean, I can't go eat fajitas and enjoy myself without feeling guilty for even enjoying myself. I don't know how to explain it. I can't even take off and go see a movie now because all I'm thinking about is the New World Order and all the stuff they're doing and how my going to a movie normalizes all of this. You know, we should be in the streets freaking out, pulling our hair out, but they just incrementally turn the tyranny up to where, you know, even I am acting insane. This is an insanely calm response to what they're doing. I mean, it's bad that they're putting fluoride in the water, and they knew it gave people cancer and attacked their glands and reduced their IQ by 20 points on average. I mean, that right there is mind-blowing. And now they're saying, yeah, melamine's good for you, mercury's good for you. Well, we used to say it was poison, but now it's good. Oh, you're dying. Good. Dying is good. It's psych warfare. They're just throwing everything in our... And, you know, I can go read all the behavioral psychologists and psychiatrists and study it and everything from Freud to Jung to Bernays right through to the modern stuff. And they are practicing just savage... It's an art form, combinations of all these different psychological schools and brainwashing techniques and TV and neuro-linguistic programming and just subliminals, just targeting, just blasting people. To where we all, just as they ambient, you know, the background noise, like crickets is an ambient sound. And then they get louder and louder and louder and louder until it just shatters your eardrums. You know, that's the analogy. They're just slowly turning the sound up, slowly. But now it's already, now they're starting to crank it even faster. And it's not ambient anymore. It's blaring all around us. Tyrannies everywhere. And people are kind of waking up, but they still have no idea how deep it is. And it's so sick when you read Prince Philip or Ted Turner or all these UN chiefs or Jacques Cousteau or Eric Pianca or a Peter Singer. There's thousands of them all writing books and papers about how 90% of us need to be killed. That's one school. The government policies, 80% of us need to be killed. And then now they're losing ground to the suicidal nihilists. That's really what it's all about. And these top scientists will, like, be writing public papers. And then they'll just say, oh, I just love death. I just want to kill. I mean, that's like Pianca. He's sitting there and he's going, oh, I love Lucifer. On the UT website, it's all about how they got to kill us and get rid of us. And then he's dressed up in a druid outfit going, I love Lucifer. On the UT website. I mean, it's craziness. This guy's running around getting standing ovations saying, kill everybody. And then his students send me threatening emails and send me their white papers, send me their PhD papers, and then I Google their name, and it's them in lab coats at bioweapons labs. And the white papers, his graduate students, send me, you know, I wrote this 5 years ago, you piece of filth, and he's actually a moderate. I believe in total human extinction. We are a parasite. They're everywhere. They run it all. It's this base power trip. And you talk to these people, at the end of the day, they're not even that smart. They are just wicked. They just like, oh, we will kill everyone. Oh, yes. It's you don't understand. I mean, you know, that's the, you don't understand. It's like, I just want to, you know, that's the response to these people is just clean them out. They declare war on us, we declare war on them! This isn't a game, people! So I do everything I can to break people out of their trance. People say, oh, don't get so excited, don't get upset. You're only allowed to get excited about the football game. That's when you're supposed to paint yourself up in war paint and simulated warfare. And it kind of tickles your mind and feels satisfying while you're there because that's an instinct to war, to defend yourself from oppression and enslavement. And they just make it into some little prosthesis, some little toy.